Hey guys, it's Lizzie. YouTube started out as something of a hobby for me. I wanted a way to let you guys into my life. I started my channel back in 2007, so many years ago. Fast forward to now, and I did not think that YouTube and my channel and my community was going to turn into such a huge, huge part of my life. I feel like more and more people are wanting to start a YouTube channel, but they haven't because they're either too nervous or they think that they might need a ton of equipment or they just don't know where to start. So I wanted to give you three really simple tips on how you can get your channel going if you decide to do so. Before every video that I upload, I look at it in three parts. Number one is, what is the story I'm going to tell? Number two is, how am I going to show it? Meaning, what camera am I going to use? Am I going to need a microphone? What type of microphone? What about lighting? Am I shooting at night or during the day? All that kind of stuff. And the third thing is, how am I going to glue it together? By that I mean, on Final Cut, am I going to make it a longer video? Am I going to need to add a lot of text or graphics? What is that going to look like? So let's break those three down and I'll give you a little bit more of an idea of what you can do for each of these three steps. The beauty of YouTube is that you can upload a video pretty much about whatever you want. Granted, the guidelines now are a little bit different from 2007, but if there's a story you want to tell about a squirrel, by all means, tell the story about a squirrel. If you want to use your channel and your videos as a way to document moments from your family, you can do that as well. You don't have to make your channel public. You can make it private, or you can have a certain members of your family or friends who you trust and approve to look at your videos. You can film them every day. You can film big moments and upload them and always be able to go back and look at those memories online. I use my channel in many, many different ways. I just recently started doing a lot of live streams and I love doing them. I used to try daily vlogging, which is really hard. A lot of people think it's easy and it's pretty difficult. Or doing videos about things that I like, or even now turning on the camera if I'm having a bad day and sort of just letting it out. It takes a lot of vulnerability to do those types of videos, but it always feels really good because more often than not, I feel like a lot of you are able to relate to the videos where I'm more real versus when I'm talking about something very generic and not going into detail about it. Back in 2007, when I first started uploading videos, I mainly only used my webcam from my white MacBook. If you have one of those, you know exactly what I'm talking about, the really big heavy one. Every video was really, really pixelated. Some videos the sound didn't even work. Some of them it wasn't synced to what was going on in the video. And for some reason, I still uploaded those videos and posted them online. After that, I started using my iPhone, and back then I don't even know which version it was, but I bought one of those little iPhone stands off of Amazon, and it's like the little tiny tripod, and I would set that up somewhere and I would just film. And it was really easy. I mean, I didn't have any big lights. I would always just go set up in front of a window. I would make sure I was filming during the day, and I just use the natural lighting. Natural lighting for me is always best, but there are moments where you might need to film at night and you have to figure out a way to do something. If you are brand new and starting your channel, I really, really want to stress that if you only have a smartphone, that's really all you need, because you don't have to pay thousands of dollars for this new hobby of yours. What I did was try it out at first, figure out what I liked and if I was actually going to stick with it, and started moving up slowly but surely with the type of camera that I used to tell a story. When it comes to sound, there are also many different ways that you can approach this. there's ways that are really simple and really, really effective. And on the other side of that, there's ways that you can buy professional microphones to hook up to your camera or to plug into your camera and have them onto your shirt, a lavalier mic. What's really cool is that you can go on Amazon, if you're using a smartphone, you can order a lavalier mic and plug it into your smartphone, and the sound is gonna be incredible. Like I said, just like the cameras, you don't have to spend a whole lot of money on equipment because there's many different ways that you can tell a story and upload that video onto your channel. Once you have your story figured out and you have filmed everything that you need, the last piece of the puzzle is editing it together. Now, this is where it gets a bit harder because it does take a bit more skill to be able to edit a video. But there's a way to make it very possible for you to be able to edit a video together even if you've never done it before. Everything I've done, whether it's filming, whether it's sound, whether it's editing, whether it's photography, videography, whatever it could be, I was self-taught, and there was always different ways that I would try to learn new things. But there was one website that really, really, really helped me, and that was Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of classes in design, technology, and more. Premium membership gives you unlimited access to high-quality classes from experts working in their fields, so you can improve your skills, unlock new opportunities, and do what you love. Skillshare helped me a ton when I was first learning to use Photoshop to make thumbnails for my videos. Since Skillshare is sponsoring this video, the first 500 people to use the link in the description will get their first 2 months free to try out Skillshare risk-free. I highly, highly suggest it, you guys, because there's so many different things that you can learn. And for me, doing these things and teaching myself always feels so much more gratifying that I learned how to do it, and that I learned how to do it versus having someone else do it for me. That is it for this video. For those of you who want to try out making your own YouTube channel, I say go for it. Why wait? All you really need is those three things. What story are you gonna tell? How are you gonna tell it? And how are you going to glue it together? And I mean, if you have Skillshare, you're gonna be able to learn so many new things and use them in so many different ways. Is that not super exciting? It is. I think it is. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you're not a part of our family, please go hit subscribe. Make sure to click the notification bell so that you can find out whenever I upload. If you have any questions or any tips, make sure to put them in the comments below. And do not forget, I will have the link for Skillshare in the description below. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!